Welcome to Surviving Schizophrenia with Stephen. My name is Stephen. I hope you're having a wonderful day. I'm here today with my dad.
I'm Steve, Stephen's dad. And Stephen, we're here to talk about regenerative brain therapy for schizophrenia. It's actually a thing. It's in phase two clinical trials in Australia. But before we get into those phase two trials in Australia and talking about our friends in Australia, can I ask you, Stephen, I mean, this is quite amazing. Regenerative brain therapy. You know, what if you can get a whole new brain, Stephen? What if you could get, you know, a more improved, you know, a better version of your brain? I mean, that's what this is all about, is regenerative brain therapy. What do you think?
Yeah, that'd be phenomenal. I mean, to have the ability to, say, regenerate my brain cells and help rebuild what my schizophrenia has damaged would be unbelievable. I would love that.
Stephen, you used the word damage, and that is so important because in talking about regenerative brain therapy, and it is actually a real thing, there's a phase two study that just started in Australia late last year, 2024. We're just the beginning here, 2025. And so this is just hot off the press, fresh news. And you talk about damage. Let's put this in perspective. Because what is schizophrenia? Schizophrenia, and this is anecdotal evidence that we have. Stephen fell ill 13 years ago. But it's a brain illness, right? It's an illness of the brain. Mm-hmm. Is it a disease? Is there a disease course? You know, researchers and our community in the world, we really don't know for sure. Although there is evidence, some evidence, that some people with schizophrenia, not everybody, that there is a disease course to the illness. It's somewhat of a degenerative brain disease. There is some evidence of that. And we have certainly seen that with Stephen when he had straight A's. When you fell ill and you're talking about damage, yes, we have seen what we believe to be, quote, damage in the brain.
Because I went pretty quickly from straight A's to lesser good grades. I went pretty quickly to not being able to do math. I went really quickly to having a lot of issues like that and not being able to focus as well and think as clearly.
Right. So that psychosis and schizophrenia is, you know, thought to be, you know, potentially caused by inflammation of the brain. But let's talk about, you know, the damage. If you can repair the damage to the brain, so schizophrenia is a brain illness. If we can repair the damage done to the brain, then we can bring the person back, right, to where they were before the illness. So regenerative brain therapy, there's a medication called SPG302 in phase two studies right now in Australia. And this is a medication developed by Spinogenics. And we are going to link to the article in the Psychiatric Times published a few months ago on this subject.
In the description.
In the description. We're going to link to the article. But this is amazing because the current therapies for schizophrenia are almost exclusively designed to treat the symptoms of schizophrenia. And that's the key difference here. So this is attempting to treat, right, with regenerative brain therapy. In other words, helping rebuild those lost connections in the brain that some researchers understand and some research has shown have been unlinked. That there's somehow in the brain that with schizophrenia that the essential links within the cells have somehow been broken or dysfunctional because maybe inflammation in the brain or for whatever reason that has happened. But so
yeah, so instead of having to take medication like I do right now, maybe to treat my psychosis and to treat all the other symptoms, my anxiety, my depression, right? And that works very well. I am not in psychosis right now, for example. But to essentially fix the actual issue, I'd have my life back.
Yeah, right. You'd have your life back, Stephen. And you know what Stephen just said? He's not in actual psychosis right now. And that's commonly misunderstood about someone suffering from schizophrenia. I think one of the common misunderstandings is that one would think that someone with schizophrenia is always kind of operating in some type of psychotic state. That's not the case. Schizophrenia is a prototypical psychosis illness. So it does require psychosis. But once on medication, the hope is that the psychosis fades and that, you know, then you can go on with your life without the psychotic element, without the psychosis.
And that's been my case.
That's exactly been Stephen's case. Now, he was in psychosis for a very long time. And unfortunately, some people with schizophrenia never come out of that psychosis, either because they're not compliant with medication, they're not taking the right medication, or simply because the disease is that severe. So it's important to understand that the psychotic portion of schizophrenia, that's lifted for Stephen now for many years, probably 8 or 9 years.
Or so.
And there's sometimes these psychotic episodes, slight psychotic episodes where Stephen might feel he's seeing something or there's something strange happening. But put that aside. What one is left with schizophrenia, it's not everyone. This is just Stephen's situation. You know, it's a very broad spectrum of potential multiple illnesses of the brain coming together. But in Stephen's case, yeah, as he said, I mean, the psychosis lifted after about 2 years, very long time. But in the last, you know, I fell ill 13 years ago, in the last 11 years, you know, we have these debilitating negative symptoms, which are social withdrawal. And then you have that, what Stephen mentioned, damage, you know, to the brain, which is just, which is manifested on a day-to-day basis, is the inability to, you know, concentrate effectively enough to, you know, hold down a job, perhaps, or to re-engage in life as Stephen had been engaged. So this regenerative brain therapy is just super exciting. It is going to the underlying
issues. Yeah, I mean, like, I can't even imagine how amazing it'd be if, like, and whenever this, if this ever happens, like in the future, right, just taking it for however long is necessary, and then, I mean, like, seeing the world in a new, not even a new way, but like a way I used to before, I can't even put into words how amazing that would be. I'd still have PTSD, that's for sure, but my life would be so much better.
Stephen, regenerative brain therapy, if this is actually proves in the future to be a treatment that is successful, you know, what does that mean to you in your life as far as your cognition, your thinking? If it can clear up your thinking, you know, what can you do and how's that going to improve your life?
Well, I think if I could, well, that's so many things. I think if I actually was able to think clearly, I might be able to have a job, potentially. Or do more YouTube, or be more productive in my life and actually do more things. I gotta imagine, not being on my antipsychotic medications as well, because in this world, I would not need it. I would be getting up at a regular time, right? I'd be waking up earlier and not getting like 12 hours of sleep and getting however much is normal for people to get sleep. And then have more of my life because I'm not sleeping most of my life. I'd be able to actually do more things in my life and lead a more productive, a happier, a healthier, a better life. I'd be able to actually do things without it stressing me out. I'd be able to hopefully get back to being more social because I might not have this anxiety as much being around people. I think having more clarity of thought would be like unbelievable, and it would just be amazing for my life, and I'd be able to do a lot more things than I already am doing and can do right now if I could regenerate my brain cells.
Yeah, just to follow on with that, Stephen, I think that you know, one of the issues with, say, even working like in a cafe where you were making coffee for people, you would be working in a group environment. It'd be noisy. There'd be, you know, customers around. So this is the real life situation that you would, I assume you would find that very difficult to be even working for a couple hours in a situation where you're in a coffee shop.
Yeah, because I have also on top of schizophrenia something called misophonia. Basically, that means certain sounds really bother me and it makes it so that I get very stressed out. For example, people eating or like a spoon hitting a plate, that kind of sound, you know, that really affects me. So, working at a coffee shop, also being around people as well, right now, I can't do that. That's too stressful. But if I didn't have all these stress and anxiety things from my schizophrenia, because that would be gone in this case, I might be able to do that.
Right, yes.
And maybe even enjoy that.
I think that's true. I mean, just to give people an understanding of like what's really going through your brain, can you just kind of place yourself hypothetically, say, as a barista behind, in a coffee shop, and you've got two or three other coworkers, you're making coffee, a lot of customers coming in, you've got all that noise, the chatter, they're drinking, coffees, you're making coffees. What would be going through your mind? I mean, you haven't done that,
No,
but
but
what?
I got an idea. Okay, so I'm behind the counter there. I'm making coffee for people. People are coming up to me, they're asking for my order. Okay. If I were doing that right now, right off the bat, I'd be worried I'm not making the right whatever kind of coffee they wanted. 'Cause I don't know, it's weird for me. I always doubt what I hear almost. So if they ask me to make them an espresso, okay, I'll make you. Did they really say espresso or did they say cappuccino?
Oh, can I hold you there? That's a very important point, Stephen. That just not,
No, go for it.
so it's a dysregulation and dysfunction in how the brain is interpreting, obviously what you're hearing, what you're seeing, and that is a core symptom of schizophrenia. There is some dysregulation there, and regenerative brain therapy is targeting, trying to fix that. So, yeah.
Yeah, so that would be a huge issue for me. Also, just the noise, people drinking, slurping maybe, people eating, right? And the noise of like all the plates and that stuff. Just a lot of people talking, like loud noises would stress me out, and in this case would really stress me out. Having to deal with other people like in a work setting. Which I've never done, but I'd imagine I'd be stressed out. Like, well, maybe I'm not doing things maybe fast enough. And, like, what are my coworkers thinking about this? Like, maybe I'm holding everything back, or they have to do more because I'm not doing the right thing, or.
So yeah, and there are therapies. There's exposure therapy, for instance. And we've talked to Stephen's psychiatrist and other therapists
Yeah,
about this,
actually.
and we have not tried over the years any systematic exposure therapy for Stephen, right? Exposing him to all kinds of noises in the hope that after learning that okay, there's no issue there. I mean, you just hear that stuff, you can put it aside. The exposure therapies can backfire. And we did talk to Stephen's psychiatrist years ago about this. It can backfire. It's hard to know,
It could totally work too, but
Yeah, it can work
I
too.
mean, I can't even imagine how stressful it'd be to like. I don't know how exactly it works, but I'm picturing sitting in a room listening to all these noises. Oh my gosh, that would be painful. It could work, but it sounds incredibly stressful to me.
Yeah, so you can see, trying to go through this with Stephen, you can see, I hope, and we hope, that, the cognitive issues that some people have with schizophrenia, not everybody, but that Stephen has with his schizophrenia, the cognitive issues is one of the core areas that cause long-term disability. That's the easiest way to put it. It's the cognitive issues. And a lot of the cognitive issues feed the negative symptoms of schizophrenia, which are the anxiety and social withdrawal. Because if you have all these cognitive issues, of course you're going to be anxious and you could get depressed and you're going to have that social withdrawal. So the cognitive issues are what are one of the hallmarks of long-term disability with schizophrenia. That's what we're dealing with here in our lives, for 13 years now. And Stephen is dealing with it in his life. And my hope is Stephen's father. Is wow, SPG302 coming out of the
That's true.
Spinogenics has developed phase two trials in for schizophrenia in Australia right now, as of late 2024. This is super exciting because it's, again, it's trying to fix the underlying issue with schizophrenia. So it's wonderful what the researchers are doing. We're here to support the researchers in any way we can.
Yeah, for sure.
So, Stephen, yeah, new brain?
Yeah.
Improved version of yourself? What do you think?
Yeah, it literally would be an improved version of me. Straight up, yeah.
Or the version that you had before falling ill.
That would be the perfect scenario.
Yeah, yes. Yeah.
So yeah, this is super exciting, and we hope you enjoyed this video.
Yeah, we hope you enjoyed the video. We'll have links to...
Yeah, links in the description below if you want to learn more about it and read it up yourself.
Yeah.
Read up about it yourself. And yeah, we hope you have a happy and healthy rest of your day. I hope to see...
And Happy New Year as well.
Thank you. Happy New Year as well. And hope to see you in the next video.
Take care. Bye-bye.